Okay. From your perspective, there's some stuff that you just kind of need to be able to do. Remember that really all we're doing is we're taking a rectangle and we are converting that rectangle into a triangle. Right? So this rectangle literally becomes this. So anything that we put inside this rectangle, like, you know, windows, archways, doors, or whatever, we can then convert and put over here. And that's the basic idea of perspective, is the idea that we're taking something that's flat and we're stretching that and translating it to create this illusion of depth and dimension. So let's take something simple. Rectangles are pretty easy. So let's take a rectangle, and we're gonna have like a big like double door kind of thing at the bottom. And then we'll take, you know, a simple long window like that. And we'll practice just translating this into perspective, right? So we already know how to do our X method subdivision. So if we do our X method, we find that the door is centered and that each one is kind of in its own half. So we can set this up. Draw out our horizon line, pick a vanishing point, grab our main vertical, complete our triangle, finish that up, and then we can go in and do our X method subdivision. So we go corner to corner, corner to corner. Then this finds us our visual center vertically, and then we go back to the vanishing point to the visual center horizontally, or horizontally in this case, scare quotes, because it's not actually horizontal, it's a diagonal going back to the vanishing point. Right? Then we can say, well, roughly above the horizon but not too far is where our door is. Put that vertical there. Remember, if this space right here needs to be bigger than this space over here, we bring it over here, boom. We draw our door back to the vanishing point, right? And we come up and we do the same. We can bring that up here, mark it off, go back towards the vanishing point, back towards the vanishing point, mark it off. And there we go. And we can come back with our alternate color, re-emphasize, and then we know that the center of the two doors is right here. So we were able to translate this into perspective using our X method. And keeping track of the center line is really important. The only thing you really need to know about the center line is that the center line is a visual center line. So on one side, the side closest to the vanishing point, that's going to be small. The side away from the vanishing point, that's going to be big. So that'll help you keep it straight. So if you're sketching, just remember big, small. Don't think about X method, subdivision, all that stuff, unless it's something really complicated that you need to do the X method. Just practice, you know, estimating. So when I'm sketching, I'll just be like, I'll just do something like this. Boom, boom. Cut, cut. Big, small. Boom. And then big, small. Cut. Window, window. Cut, cut. There we have it, right? And come back, clean it all up. and so on. Anyway, but you can do other shapes in there too. Like, let's say you had a triangle in there, right? And for the sake of simplicity, we'll have the triangle align with the center, right? If we do this X method, boom, boom, our triangle is in the center. Okay, so then we can go over, we can translate, boom, 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 X method. We got a vertical here. This is actually above halfway, so we should probably go ahead and do the halfway mark. And then we can come in with our triangle, right? And so it's gonna be bigger distance here, smaller distance here, from here to here, and from here to here. And then it's probably not quite, maybe like a little over, a little under half up there. We got triangle, triangle. And then we have found our triangle on this plane in perspective. The next component to this is basically just gonna be, you know, we take this door frame, right? That we've got right here. And the door frame itself needs depth. So we'd have to go back in perspective with the door frame, right? So that's kind of the next stage, is taking these things and then insetting them in perspective as well. So that's where we're headed in the next sort of part of this.